Welcome everyone for the afternoon session, which will start with a demo and will be followed by a lab. So we have for this demo SQL injection. What Nikhil is going to show you is one vulnerable application. He has already installed it and he's going to attack it. So he's going to describe this application and describe to some extent what is expected of you in the lab. Also, don't forget that this lab involves Wireshark, where you will look at the transfer of information between a client and a server, which has been encrypted using SSL, the handshake as well as the record layer protocol. So with that, I let Nikhil start his demo on SQL injection.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I will give a quick overview of SQL injection, and then I will show you the demo of SQL injection. So what is an SQL injection? SQL injection is a type of software vulnerability often found in web applications. It occurs when a web application uses the input user input to retrieve some data or information from the database without sanitizing the user input properly. It means that the user input is placed as it is in the SQL query before that query is submitted to the database. So therefore, the user may enter some malicious SQL statements that will be placed in the SQL query, and then this SQL query will be executed on the server side. A successful SQL injection exploit can read sensitive data from the database, such as username or password, modify the database, such as creating or deleting the entry from the database, or drop the database table entirely, and many more. I will now show you the demo of SQL injection. For this, I am going to use one application known as DVWA, Damn Vulnerable Web Application. So this is a web application, Damn Vulnerable Web Application. This web application is deliberately made vulnerable to different types of attacks, such as XSS attack, SQL injection attack, CSRF attacks, etc., so that the beginners can learn and understand these attacks. So we will now log in into this DVWA application. Username is admin and password is password by default. So on the home page, you can see that there are different types of attacks on the left side of the window. Here you can see there is CSRF attack, there is SQL injection attack, there is XSS reflected, XSS stored attacks. This web application provides three different types of security levels: low, medium, and high. In the security level low, it is very easy to hack into it. In the security level medium, it is somewhat difficult. And when the security level is set to high, it is very difficult to break. So initially, we are going to set the security level to low. Just select the security level low and submit. So here you can see security level is set to low. Is everyone able to see that? Fine. Now we will go to the SQL injection part over here. Now here you can see that suppose this application is asking for the secret ID of the user. It means that when the user enters his secret ID, some information will be displayed related to that user. Here this ID, secret ID, is very confidential to the user. It means that one user doesn't know the secret ID of another user. It is very confidential, only one user knows the ID of his own. There is a database stored on the server side. And there you can edit the schema. Like you can edit the name of number of columns, name of the columns, and entries in it. Okay. Now suppose my secret ID is 4234 and enter. So here you can see that it is displaying the secret ID, first name Nikhil, my surname, and credit card number. This is my credit card number. Okay. So what's happening is there is a database already stored on the server. This application takes the secret ID from the user, searches that ID in the database, and displays all the records corresponding to that ID. So we will have a look at the source code of the server. So here you can see the source code by clicking on this view source button. So this is the source code of the server. Here the user input is assigned to this variable ID, and then this variable ID is placed directly into the SQL query. This is the SQL query: select first name, last name, credit card number from table users where condition user ID is equal to this ID, and this ID is placed between single quotes. I will write this query on a page. Credit, select first name, last name, credit card number from data table name users where user ID is equal to this. ID between, in between double single quotes. So when I enter my input as 4234, this is placed over here, that is the user ID is now 4234, and this is searched against the record in the database, and when it finds the match, it will, it shows the it shows all the record, it shows all the entries corresponding to this ID. Now this is what I have shown you, how this application was, means it asks for secret ID and displays the information. Now suppose I am an attacker and I want to look at the credit card number of another user. So how can I start with? I can enter some random secret ID, suppose 1234, and nothing is shown over here. Suppose I enter 2389, again there is nothing shown over here. So because it is not showing any information, because there is no record stored in the database corresponding to this ID. So we cannot continue with this method because it may not give us the result that we want. So for this purpose, I am going to do SQL injection over here. Now whenever you have to check whether an application is vulnerable to SQL injection or not, you should start by entering a single quote in the input field. So suppose I enter over here 1 and then quote. So let's see what happens now. Now it is saying something. You have an error in SQL syntax error. So it is saying that there is a SQL syntax error at this line number, at line 1 in my SQL server. Why this is giving an error? Because the on the server side, the database has received an input and it has thrown an error, and that error is shown to the user. So why this has thrown an error? So now the input was 1 quote. Fine. Therefore the user ID was quote, 1 quote, and then quote. Fine. And obviously this is a wrong syntax, and therefore it had given a syntax error. So now if a web application shows such kind of error to the user, then it may be possible that it is vulnerable to SQL injection attack. Also this error shows information, some information about the server, like what database is being used on the server side. Here my SQL server is used. Now once we have this information about the database that is used on the server and how the query is processed, what will happen if the input is 1 or 1 quote or quote 1 quote 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 1. The input is 1 quote, then OR condition, then quote 1 quote equal to quote 1. So what will happen when this is given as an input? Okay. Then the user ID will look like, here there are 2 quotes already. Here this is the input, 1 quote or quote 1 quote equal to quote 1. So what do you think, what should be the output? Is there any syntax error or something else? So what do you think, what will happen?
Credit card number of all the credit cards.
Right. Because now the user ID has this OR conjunction, where the first part may or may not be true, but the second part is always going to be true. Okay. So let's try and put this attack vector in the web application. So this is one quote OR, quote one quote equal to quote one, and let's see what it's showing. As you can see, it is showing all the records that are stored in the database. Secret ID, the first name, last name, Deepak Suel, it's his credit card number. Again, another user, Naman Jain, his credit card number. So why this has happened? Because the SQL query was select first name, last name, credit card number from users where user ID was this. Here, as I said, the second part is always true. Therefore, when this user ID is matched against the records in the database, it is going to be true for all the records, and therefore it displays all the records that are stored in the database. Similarly, we can have another attack vector that will again display all the records that are stored in the database, like one or one equal to one, semicolon, and then hash. So the SQL query is select first name, last name, credit card number from users where user underscore ID is. So now the input is one quote or one equal to one semicolon hash. Therefore, the user ID will become one quote, then one quote or one equal to one semicolon hash, and then quote. So is there any syntax error again over here? The user ID is quote one quote or one equal to one semicolon, then hash, and then single quote. Is there any error, or this attack vector will work? Three quotes there because of this one. Yeah, that's right. Here the semicolon over here will end the SQL query, and the hash part will comment out whatever is going to be after it. So the final query will be something select first name, last name, credit card number from users where user ID equal to quote one quote or one equal to one semicolon. And again, this is going to be true for all the records in there, and therefore it will show all those. So let's see. And again, it shows all the records that are stored in the database. So as you can see, it shows all the records that are stored in there. We'll try it once again. One or one quote or one equal to one semicolon, and then hash, and then submit. So again, it shows all the records that are stored. Okay. So this was for the security level low. Now we'll change the security level to medium and try to again get all the records or do some similar kind of attack. Security level medium, submit. Back to the SQL injection. Now, before proceeding, anyone has any doubts?
Can you show the PHP code for this?
Yeah, sure. Should I explain this code? This is a PHP code. I have not created this. This is the source code stored on the server. This is the source code of the server. This is the source code of the web application. I'm just an user of this web application.
Is there any way that if I have built one SQL scanner, and is there any way that I have to check whether that scanner is working properly, if it is whether it is defending against all kind of SQL attacks or not?
Yeah.
Then is there any way or application available?
are you asking about tools or?
Tool, yes.
Yeah, there are tools actually. We are going to talk about it tomorrow. So you can find what are the vulnerabilities that are there. Now we'll move to the security level to medium. Submit. Again, SQL injection. Now we'll try the same attack vector that we used in the previous case and let's see whether it works or not. So the attack vector was one quote or quote one quote equal to quote one. Okay. Let's see what it gives now. Now it is showing an error. Again, it is saying there is an SQL syntax error in MySQL server for this one. So this was our input actually, quote or one quote one. So I'll write it down on the paper. The input was one quote or quote one quote equal to quote one. And it is showing this error at this point. So what is that error? Is yeah, they're actually escaping those special characters. So this is the error. If you see that the server has appended a backslash before every quote that has entered in the input, right? So that it means that the server is using some kind of protection to prevent this SQL injection. Okay. So it means that now we can't enter these special characters, one quote, or we can't enter this kind of attack. You know. So can you think of an attack vector that will bypass this security mechanism? We have given you a small exercise on this SQL injection on how to find out the column name, number of columns, even bypassing this security mechanism, and think of the attack vector and do it in the lab session. So what is the info?
One quote slash along with the quote.
Okay, one slash, then quote. Yeah. Zoom into it. Again.
Same, whatever you return, one slash, one quote. Nah.
Okay, fine. Okay, so you mean to say that one quote, before the quote there is a slash. Yeah. Or
slash quote one again slash equal to submit it.
So again it is throwing an error. Mm-hmm. At the same point.
Because here
the backslash is also slash. A special character and yeah, it is trying to escape that.
Yeah, it's happening one more slash.
Can you tell me the attack vector input?
Enclose the single quote into a double quote. Into a pair of double quotes.
Okay. Fine. Let me try. More quote one. Quote one. Double quote one.
No. Put a single quote in the pair of double quotes.
You can try as this many attack vectors as you want in the lab session. And if you need any. Again, there is an error because it tries to escape that double quotes also. So you can try such attack vectors in the lab session, and if you need any help, then any of the TS will help you. Code is different because there is some defense mechanism that is being. So the change in the code is this one, MySQL real escape string. This function is applied to the user input. So what it does is it appends backslash before every special character that is occurring in the input.
With that, we finish the presentations. I think we can head to the labs and try out all these attack vectors and the rest of the assignments.